لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ومولانا محمد حبيبنا وشفيعنا وعلى آله وأصحابه أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. صدق الله العظيم. Dear brothers and dear students who can understand English, first of all, we would like to request the brothers who are understanding this to come forward. So there's youngsters who are sitting against the wall for them to come forward. It is one of the sunnah of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that when they listen to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in such a way that they will never leave gaps between themselves. And the Prophet forbid this. He told his companions not to sit in a way leaving gaps, because the shaitan will sit in that position, in that gap between the people. Jazakumullah. The reason we have gathered today is the monthly gathering of what we call Yanu Sharif. The word Yanu comes from the word Sinuku from Yara, meaning 11. And the significance of this is that this is the day in which Sayyidina Abdul Qadir al-Jilani radiallahu ta'ala anhu, one of the greatest awliya, passed away. And it's this day he used to hold a gathering in Baghdad, in his Zawiya, in his Madrasa in Baghdad, on the 11th. And this was carried, this act of holding the gathering was continued by his disciples and students. There is certain narrations saying that Sayyidina Abdul Qadir al-Jilani passed away on the 9th. Abdul Haq Muhaddis Sadebi, a great scholar from India, about 500 to 600 years ago, writes in his book, Ma Sabata Min al-Sunnah. This is the name of his book. He says that the authentic date of the wasal, the passing away of Sayyidina Abdul Qadir al-Jilani radiallahu ta'ala anhu, is 11. And this is why we hold a gathering on the 11th. So Sayyidina Abdul Haq Muhaddis Sadebi rahmatullahi alayh, one of the greatest scholars who ever set foot in India, not only mentioned the date, the wasal of Sayyidina Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, but mentioned that he himself practiced the Yanu Sharif. And who is this Abdul Qadir? Abdul Haq Muhaddis Sadebi. It's narrated, and Imam Ahmad al-Razaa radiallahu ta'ala anhu also narrates it, and calls him Barakatul Mustafa fil Din. The Baraka, the blessing of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in India. And the reason why we call him that it has a story behind it, and that story being that once Sayyidina Abdul Haq Muhaddis Sadebi rahmatullahi alayhi went to Medina Sharif. Sayyidina Hajjah went to Medina Sharif. And because the love of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he wanted to stay there in Medina and not return back to India, to Delhi. So once he made his intention, he saw in his dream, he saw that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has come to him and has ordered Abdul Haq Muhammad Sadebi to go back to India and teach my hadith, teach my tradition and my teaching. So because of this dream, Abdul Haq Muhaddis Sadebi rahmatullahi alayhi came back to India. And this is why we remember him as the barakah And the blessing of Sayyidina Rasulullah from the community of Bukhari, he was sent by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this person was also practicing from before the Yamin Sharif, this actual gathering. And this gathering is in remembrance of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam Yusuf Nabhani rahmatullahi in his book Jami' Karamat al-Awliya. He was around in the early 19th century. He was the Mufti of Beirut at this time in the Ottoman Empire. He wrote a book called Jami' Karamat al-Awliya, and in that book, in the introduction of Sayyidina Abdul Qadir al-Jilani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he says, Ijtama'atul Ummah ala walayatihi, that there's a consensus of the Ummah of Muhammadiyah, the nation of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Sayyidina Abdul Qadir Jilani is a friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he is from the Awliya. And not just the Sufiya and the people from the Ahl Sunnah who accept this, but people like Ibn Taymiyyah, who is regarded as one of the Imams of the Wahhabiyya, he mentions that the karamat of Sayyidina Abdul Qadir al-Jilani are mutawatir. What does that mean? That means that the miracles that were given to Sayyidina Abdul Qadir al-Jilani wa radiyallahu ta'ala anhu have been narrated to us. Nare Takbir, Nare Risale, Ulama al-Sunnah. Sayyidina Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, the miracle of Sayyidina Abdul Qadir al-Jilani of Allah Ta'ala has been narrated to us mutawatiran. What that means is that his miracles have been narrated chain by chain with much narration to a point that it is impossible for us to reject that these miracles have took place. So it is compulsive upon us to believe, and then having mentioned the ijma of the Muslims upon the reliance of Sayyidina Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, that we remember such a person. And the lessons we learn from the life of Sayyidina Abdul Qadir al-Jilani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu are great. The way he set up from his place in Gilan, modern day Iran, and traveled to Baghdad for the sake of knowledge. The way he spent almost 20 or 25 on one narration years in the jungles around Baghdad and on the way to Baghdad, seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Sayyidina Abdul Qadir al-Jilani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, it is said that he was shadeed al-malazama bil kitab al-sunnah, that he was firmly take hold of the Quran and Sunnah and will not leave the command of the Quran and Sunnah. And he said, kalazum zillil shakhs, like the shadow follows the body, Sayyidina Abdul Qadir al-Jilani radiyallahu anhu follows the shidda. And there's a lesson in that for us. The lesson that walaya, that friendship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is not gained by a jahil, a person who has no knowledge. Allah azza wa jalla, and he offers his friendship to those people who are people of knowledge. The people who know his commands, know the narrations and the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and know the difference between halal and haram. Here one might think that whatever you say about Sayyidina Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, رضي الله تعالى عنه,